I'm Lisa Norden, I'm competing in the triathlon and I represent Sweden. I had one race before London that was good in Kitzbühel, and then I had an injury after that. We'd had a lot of pain and I couldn't run for 2 weeks. Just went into London like, okay, my goal with this race is to leave here knowing I have given it everything I had. I want to leave everything out on that course and go home and felt happy with the performance and what I did. And I did, and I got so much more back than what I ever expected. There's so much focus when you're on the pontoon. You see that first buoy. You know exactly what you need to do when you dive into the water. And you just try to cut everything away in terms of the size of the race and the amount of people lined up on the side watching you. I was a bit stuck. Most of the top-ranked athletes were on the very left-hand side. And we're swimming about the same pace, which meant we are not really getting away, you're swimming very quickly, so we're a bit bunched up together. And I know I could see on the right-hand side that there were some people swimming really quickly. I expected to see all my, you know, big opponents and competitors up in that bunch. And I came out and I saw Helen, I saw Groffy, and all the good girls I thought was going to be up ahead of me. I was like, actually, this is not too bad. So I was pretty happy with things were at and just trying to stay out of trouble, really. Obviously, there was a bit of drama on the first lap already and on the second lap. And I was very, very close to go down in one of the corners. I had Emma Moffat going down just ahead of me, and I had to do a bit of work to catch back up to the front pack after that. So I knew transition was going to be absolutely crucial, and I'd been drilled by my coach the importance of coming in early in the pack of the bike and then have a really quick transition and be out among the front girls. And I just remember thinking like, yes, I nailed it. I had a brilliant transition running out in second position. When you do that, you can just relax a bit and, you know, let the other girls catch up to you and see, you know, where you're running at, and you have control of the race from the early stages of the run. So I remember running out thinking like, okay, brilliant, Lisa, that's, you know, good job done here. I was waiting for someone to start to run really, really fast, just preparing myself that the pace is going to go up and this is going to get a lot harder very soon. So at this stage, we're now four, and I remember thinking, there's three medals and we're four. That's not good. Like, we need to be three people so we all get a medal here. I remember telling myself, like, Lisa, this is the most important day in your life. You got to do something about this. You know, you have this brilliant opportunity to do something I'm never maybe going to be able to do again. So just, you know, focus and get yourself together here. I knew Nicola was going to go for it. And I knew I just had to wait for her to start sprinting. I kind of knew I was in the middle, but the focus, here we go, here's Nicola start sprinting, and I'm just a little bit slow to react to it, but once I get my speed up, I do finally get my momentum and I get my rhythm and I can feel I'm gaining and gaining and gaining and actually almost getting there. The only thing I can see at the time is the finish line, knowing that I have to give it, you know, absolute everything I have. But I had no idea who was ahead or who wasn't. It's probably the most focused I've ever been in my life, you know. You have so many people around you and still, like, the only thing you can see or focus on is that little line that's up ahead of you that, you know, you need to get there as fast as you can. For me, the silver itself and in the way it was run, I was definitely not disappointed, like a lot of people asked me afterwards. But when I throw my hands in the air here, I'm just, you know, so pleased to have a medal. My family's on the grandstands and now it's a good day. It's a dream coming true, for sure. You have a lot of expectations and dreams, but very, very few of them kind of turns real like this. It's a very, very proud moment, for sure.